Hi, my name is Jonas, just like the shit song in the 90s, and I'm here to give you the 10 most important things to do to earn thousands of dollars in collecting vinyls. First of all, as usual, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, pound that bell, and give us a thumbs up. That will really help us out. Okay, so with that out of the way, who am I to give advice on vinyls? I'm not 80 years old. I both look good and smell good, and I have earned my living just as long. So here are 10 bulletproof ways to make money on your vinyls, and I'm giving this away for free. Number one, be the record. This is the hardest one, and maybe the most important one. You have to become the record. Live, breathe, and eat vinyl records. Be the Mr. Miyagi of the vinyl community. When you got your wax on and wax off on, you are ready. Number two, achieve experience. You have to have many years in this business to rock the title of a record seller and to get the respect that you really deserve, so you can look down on the newbies. It's like this. If they have only been in this business for like 2 to 5 years, and the only thing they are is like super enthusiastic over the music or the format, let them know that they suck and talk shit about them in their faces on the internet. Number three, and this is the easiest one, be a man. It's just like the old saying, and it's true. Girls have no business in the vinyls business. Girls just don't want to collect stuff. Vis-a-vis, they don't have what it takes to collect records. Science. Number four, neglect loved ones. You will spend all your waking hours on vinyls. So unfortunately, you will neglect friends and loved ones. Say nay to dinners, say nay to social events, say nay to gatherings. That's for suckers and newbies. You are beyond that. And besides, this is just feelings, and feelings have never hurt anyone. A lot of people ask me, well, Jonas, wouldn't it be better if you didn't have a family? And to them I say, hell no. One more income is great for the records, and every child you get is one child benefit that goes right into the vinyl budget. And number five, and this is the absolute best tip for today, and I'm giving it away for free. This is the one tip that the business don't want you to know. The three P's. Old people, poor people, and dead people. Old people equals old records, poor people equals cheap records, and dead people equals free records. If you manage to hit any one of these, you are bound for a home run. If you find a old, poor guy and he dies, that's what we call a hat trick in the business. And talking about business, here's a little message from this week's sponsor. Amazon is a little harmless mom and pop shop on the internet that provides good old hard-working Americanized people like you and me a service that is both affordable and effective. In today's hard corporate climate, it's small stores on the corner like Amazon that still keeps the flag waving. Be smart. Get used by Amazon. Use this promo code to get half off shipping when putting in your next order. Thanks, Amazon. Next week's sponsor will be the Third Reich. Number six, shop for money you don't have. In the Middle Ages, we had money put under our mattresses or in our pockets, but not anymore. Why? Evolution. Nowadays, money is just numbers on internet, and there's no shortage of numbers, are there? Just go for it, and future you will thank you. Number seven, ignore unimportant economical factors. Big words? Yeah, maybe, but stuff like shipping or gas money or food are just unimportant economical factors. It's like this, what you pay for a record is what you log on your Discogs account. That's what you paid for it. Everything else is just stupid and dumb. Number eight, free records on Discogs. But how, you say? Well, it's easy. Buy a record from a good seller on Discogs and be the nicest person you have ever been. When you get the record and it's exactly like you expected it to be, look for imperfections. And then you take those small imperfections and throw it in the guy's face. Be a douche and a dick and demand a refund. Otherwise, you will give him a bad review. Remember, good reviews is what these people live for. So take that flaw in the system and use it to your advantage. Number 9. RSD. No, it's not a venereal disease. Or is it? It's like this. Once or twice every year you have to set an alarm and get up to go to be first in line. It's called Record Store Day. But don't be fooled, because it has nothing to do with records, stores, or even a day. It's just a way for the corporates to make insane amounts of money, several days every year, selling records that everyone already have or don't need, which clogs up the pressing plants for actual releases, so the people of the community can hate on each other even more. But enough of the truth, and you go to one of the big stores, and don't go to a small store, cause they get shit. So go to one of the big stores. If you do that, you can buy up most of the sought-after vinyls and go home, put it on eBay and Discogs for like 100 times what it costs. This will earn you heaps of money. Now, unlike my other tips, this may stir up a little bit of feelings in the vinyl community. But don't mind the simple-minded and uneducated people. There's always a new day around the corner. And number 10, make the few stores that are left your friends. For years I have worked the stores so they know who I am. This is mostly achieved by not taking no for an answer. You see, record stores are just out to take your money. They will throw stuff in your face like tax or social fees and rent. Like it was your problem. At the end of the day, their biggest weakness is that they often have families to feed. So if you want to buy that record, be persistent. Just haggle it down to a point where people around you get very uncomfortable. And don't take no for an answer. Make up excuses why you shouldn't buy it for the price that it actually costs, like a sucker or a newbie. After a while, the store will know your name. So that's my 10 best tips on how to make money on your vinyls. Stay tuned for more fantastic tips in the vinyl world. And don't forget to subscribe, hit that bell, and give us a thumbs up. We would really appreciate that. So, until next time, bye.